Hello and welcome to the Cliffs Bandstand, where we're here at part of the Southend Arts Festival. Behind me there's a tea dance taking place, lots of dancing there, and I'd be joining in if I could dance. We're then going to move to Southend High Street and see some of the other activities that have been on offer during the festival. There's action art, performance art and performances for musicians.
The more I see you, the more I want you. Somehow this feeling just grows and grows. With every sigh, I become more mad about you. My life without you, and so it goes.
I'm speaking to Sharon Goodman, who's coordinator of the Southend Arts Festival. Sharon, tell me a bit about the background to the festival.
Right, we started 2 years ago. This is our second year. And it's just that there's so much going on in Southend, art, music, theatre and so on. And a lot of these places are only getting the same audiences all the time. And what I wanted to do was try and spread this so that everyone knew about it. Everyone in Southend can be a part of the festival. So we've been doing things where you can go and sit and watch, but equally we've had demonstrations of artwork, workshops with art, drama workshops, music workshops, so people can actually join in, which has been fantastic.
Can you talk me through what you're doing, Richard?
Well, all I do is spray the colours, what I'm going to use, just roughly on the paper first, and then bits of newspaper, bits of sponge, different tools, I turn it into a picture.
What's this picture going to be? Do you know yet?
Yeah, it's going to be a blue jungle, what I call a blue jungle. It's sort of, it'll have a waterfall in it, trees, planets and stuff like that.
You have to be quite precise about where you spray that paint. How do you manage to get it exactly where you want it?
Well, it's just luck really. And when you're doing it outside with the wind, you just hope it goes where you want it to.
What's on my jacket?
Spray you, see?
How long will it take you to finish this particular painting?
Well, this one's a bit fiddly, about 5 minutes, 4 minutes.
And you've got paintings all round you. Some of them look as if they take quite a lot of work. Is that true?
No, not really. It's just, it's all quick because it's only a fine mist of paint and it dries quick, so you've got to work quick.
Looks very impressive, thanks very much. Karen with me now, who's going to teach me how to do some spin art. Karen, how's it done?
Okay, well I'll demonstrate, that'll be the best thing. I use the white and then you can cover it up afterwards and do your own thing, okay? There's several ways of doing it. You can either drop it on slowly, just bit by bit, different colours. Or you can start from the outside, just squeeze lightly and go in towards the middle. Or you can go the other way round. Middle to the outside. You can build it up in bands, different colours. Or if I demonstrate, you can do two together. What colour would you like me to use with the white?
And what about that purple there?
That one there? Ah.
You're obviously an expert. It looks quite impressive there.
It's remarkably easy to do. Anybody can be an artist and produce a unique work of art in a matter of minutes. You don't get messy. We do, but you don't.
You've helped to discover some undiscovered geniuses then, have you?
Absolutely, yes, absolutely. And a fraction of the cost of a Jackson Pollock, you can own your own work of art. What other colour would you like to pour? Shall I show you the effect of the two together?
Yes, that would be good.
I'll stop it first and then you can have a look. It sort of feathers together, it mixes together.